Dr. Sheila says some of the units in the hospital, like the theater, are heavily dependent on water.
Pay our water bills timely, because this depends on when the release comes. But our budget allocation is not adequate enough to cater for this consumption. So what we receive is not in position to cater fully for what has been consumed by the patients. But also our water bills are high. There have been a few challenges because of the infrastructure and the usage of the patients.
Area leaders have appealed to government to come to their rescue because a looming water shortage threatens cholera response activities at the hospital.
Your water. Water was disconnected from this place about 4 days ago. Why? Because the hospital owes National Water about 1.3 billion shillings. And so they were disconnected. The hospital says the challenge they have is that their monthly water bill is about 50 million shillings. But the money they receive from government, from the Ministry of Health, is less than 10 million shillings per month. So you're meant to pay a water bill of 50 million, but you're getting less than 10 million shillings per month. There's just no way you're going to...
They have appealed to both entities to work together to serve Ugandans. Medics say the facility depends largely on water supply from the National Water and Sewerage Corporation, and due to water scarcity, the hospital administration has started referring patients in other hospitals like Kirudu and Mulago.
Oh, forget about critical elements like healthcare. So people are here. In fact, they are being referred to different hospitals, to Kirudu, to Mulago. Why? Because there's no water. Those who come sick, they leave this place worse off than they came. It's a real problem. You know, I've spoken to the PS Minister of Health, Dr. Diana Atwine. She says, well, they are trying to engage finance. I've spoken to finance. They're also saying, well, okay, we are trying to see how we give them a commitment and so on. I've told them, look, fix your issues as government, but let's not let these people here suffer.
Oliver Namazi and Moses Mugisha Okwela, the area councillors, are dismayed by the action that was taken by the National Water and Sewerage Corporation to disconnect water supply from the hospital, denying Ugandans access to get medical services, yet they pay taxes. They have appealed to government to increase on the hospital budget since it handles very many patients.
Essentials in any hospital facility. So our request to government is to handle it at an highest speed, because most of our ladies from these areas, Mutungo, Mbuya, Kishwa, Koto, Tinda, they all give birth from Naguru Referral Hospital before they leave for Mulago. So our request is government to handle this thing at the highest, because the National Water belongs to government. Government, so it's as if the government is fighting government. So.
Thank you.